In the previous videos, what we talked about was the electric field, which is a field that all charges produce. It's a vector field, so every point in space will have a number and a direction associated with the electric field when there are charges present. In this video, what we're going to do is we're going to talk about a different kind of field, the electric potential, which is a scalar field. So it's much like the temperature field. Everywhere in space has a number that would be associated with the electric potential due to charges. So the thing that the electric potential tells you a little bit about is what we'll call the landscape of energy associated with the charges. And so, as you'll see in a moment, it sort of gives you a sense of how the energy is distributed in space, but also can tell you a little bit about how charges would interact if they were in the presence of the source charges. So what we're going to start with is we're going to talk about a point charge first, and the potential associated with that. And so when we go out and we make measurements of this, what we find is that the electric potential, which is given this letter V, can be mathematically described as 1 over 4 pi epsilon 0 times the charge divided by the separation distance. So this looks kind of similar to the electric field formula that you saw earlier. Here, this constant out front is the same constant that we saw before. It sort of characterizes the interaction between charged particles and tells you a little bit about how that interaction scales compared to gravitational interactions and magnetic interactions and so forth. This guy here is the charge that we're actually interested in. It can be positive or negative. It can take on, you know, one coulomb or nanocoulomb value or what have you. And this here is that separation distance that we talked about in the last video, but it's just its magnitude, right? So it's very much like the formula that we saw before, except it's scalar. There's no vector information. And the dependence on the separation is 1 over the separation as opposed to 1 over the separation squared. So this electric potential gives us a sense of how the energy is distributed in space. Every point in space takes on some value of the electric potential when a charge is present. So let's get an image of that. So we'll graph this. So if we look at the electric potential, which is going to be have units of volts versus position, we will have a graph that takes on the shape of sort of a 1 over r drop-off. So it'll have this sort of characteristic shape that looks like this. It falls off like 1 over r. As you get really, really close to the charge, which would be here, you know, at r equals 0, that potential blows up. In fact, it's not defined at the location of the point charge. A point charge is a construct, right? It's this thing that has charge but takes up no space. It's sort of infinitely small. But as you get away from it, it falls off. It dies off and goes towards zero, right? So how does this actually describe the landscape of energy? Well, if you think about this, this separation vector from the charge to somewhere out in space actually is three-dimensional. It's sort of described everywhere in space. So we can take this and make a representation of it that tells us a little bit about the way that the energy landscape looks if we go into sort of a two-dimensional shape. So what we'll do is we'll say, put a positive charge down somewhere, and if we're really far away from it and we come in, the potential sort of shoots up as we get close to the charge. If we start on the other side and do the same thing, it turns out to have exactly the sort of mirror image across the charge. And in fact, in any direction that you come in, it kind of looks like that. So we could come in from into the board or out of the board or what have you. But what you start to see is you get this sense of like there's this kind of, you know, hill sort of showing up here. And that's what we mean by landscape. So the idea being that this tells you a little bit about what would happen if you put another positive charge nearby, right? Your experience with like charges is that they repel. This gives you a sense of kind of how that might happen, right? If we were to put a positive charge nearby, it would in a sense roll down this energy hill, if you will. It's not exactly rolling or anything like that, right? But this just gives you a sense of an analogy of how this would work. And similarly, if you have a negative charge, right, what ends up happening is this Q takes on a minus sign, so everything is just mirror flipped. So instead of a hill, you end up with sort of a well, right? And in your experience, positive charges are attracted to negative charges, and this gives you sort of a sense of how that might work, right? A positive charge will kind of roll into the well here and in a sense be trapped, and that's precisely what would happen. So this is just an introduction to the electric potential for a point charge, just to give you a sense of what the formula for it looks like, what the sort of shape of that potential looks like, and how you can sort of think about it and how it might connect to energy, which is what we're going to talk about in a little bit.